to 1968. That's Zoot. 1 × 2 × 3 × 4. And playing bass guitar on that track is our guest today in the Legends series, Beeb Birtles, direct from Nashville, Tennessee. Of course, we know him from Little River Band and many other acts across the decades. Welcome to 101 FM, Beeb.
Thank you so much for having me on your program.
It is a great pleasure, and I got to ask you what you think when you hear that track from Zoot back to 1968.
Well, the first thing that goes through my mind is just how young we were at that time, and because it's, you know, over 50 years ago or something. We were just getting started, really. That song was written by Terry Britton from the Twilights. And just the other day, actually, there was an exchange on Facebook about this fantastic club where Zoot made their debut in Melbourne. It was called Bertie's. And, it was the very, very first appearance of us in all of our pink glory. And that would have been one of the songs we played.
And what a band it was, with Daryl Cotton, Rick Springfield, yourself, and the way that it kind of all kind of came together in such a dynamic way.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, you know, we were an Adelaide band, of course, and actually shortly after we had moved to Melbourne, two of the guys decided to leave, and then we went through, you know, some member changes. Rick Brewer joined us on drums, and then Roger Hicks was our first guitar player before Rick Springfield joined. But it was really when Rick Springfield joined when our music started to change and become more, it was taken more seriously. So we kind of, you know, evolved from being a teeny bopper band into a band that was taken more seriously when we started recording songs like Hey Pinky and Eleanor Rigby, of course, which was the song that we were most known for.
Yeah, the rocky version of the Beatles classic. 1964 to 71, you were together with Zoot, but there was a reunion before Daryl Cotton died, sadly, about a decade ago in 2011. What was that like?
That was fantastic. Actually, the both Rick and Daryl were really surprised that I would agree to do it. For some reason, they thought that I wasn't interested in doing it, but I thought it was a great opportunity, and we just had such a fantastic time playing all those songs again. It was on a 5-day cruise that Rick Springfield puts together for his many, many female fans, and one night featured Zoot. And we played all of our songs that we were known for, plus some more. And it was just a great, fantastic night. And it was memorable from the point of view that, it was Daryl's last appearance with us as a group.
Yeah, very, I guess looking back now, I guess it was very, very special to be with him in the band of Zoot. And then after Zoot, there was Mississippi before Little River Band formed. How did that get mm-hmm. together with Graeham Goble and Derek Pellicci?
Well, when Zoot broke up, you know, Daryl and I were in a duo for a year. It was called Frieze. But I wasn't really happy doing the duo thing. I really missed being in a band. And after that year was over, I told Daryl that wasn't for me. And, shortly after that, I heard the first Mississippi album that was recorded with Kings of the World on it. And I was so taken with their harmonies and their musicianship that I was desperate to be in that group. And Graeham Goble phoned me and asked me to join the group. And when he heard our voices together, he just was convinced that I was the right guy to join the band. So that's how I made my entry into Mississippi. And, of course, Mississippi was a very hard-working band back in the days of when pub rock was really happening. And we traveled all over Australia playing our music, and finally ended up going to on a ship playing our way over to England.
Well, from Mississippi, it became Little River Band. Beeb Birtles is our guest, direct from Nashville, Tennessee. Let's play one of the first big hits of LRB as we keep Beeb Birtles on the line here in the Legends series.
When you say, now you cut that jive right now.
Listening to Curiosity Killed the Cat by Little River Band, taking us back to 1975. Got to number 15 on the charts. Beeb Birtles, who wrote it, on the line, direct from Nashville, Tennessee. I understand this was written about Graeham Goble's cat. Is that correct, Beeb?
Yeah, it is correct. It's true. I shared a house in London when Mississippi had moved there, and Graeham and his wife Narelle adopted this little kitten that they had, and it was just running around the living room one day, and I thought, you know, I've always been a fan of proverbs, and you know, that proverb popped into my head, curiosity killed the cat, when I saw this little kitten just jumping around it, and it sparked the interest to want to write that song.
Well, as a teenager growing up in Sydney at the time, it made a big impression on me. I loved the song. It really kind of hooked me. But this was the time when, you know, you transitioned from Mississippi into Little River Band. Tell us about the magic that came together with so many, you know, superstars in that band, and why it was so successful compared to Mississippi.
Well, I think, you know, Mississippi, we were, in that band, I think we were just, you know, five or six, maybe six musicians. We didn't really have a lead singer. And when Mississippi broke up in London, three of us, Graeham, Derek Pellicci, the drummer, and I, sat around talking about why we, you know, Mississippi wasn't the biggest success than we thought it should have been. And we narrowed it down to the fact that we didn't have a good front man who could be the liaison between the audience and the group. And so I said to the guys in that particular meeting, I said, well, the best guy I can think of is Glenn Shorrock. And Glenn happened to be in London at that time. He'd been doing various things over there, and he was getting ready to travel back to Australia. So we invited Glenn to come over to the house where we were staying, and we sat around and, you know, played each other some songs that we'd written. And then we had a bit of a sing song, and we put our voices together for the beginning of It's a Long Way There. And when we heard our voices just in a room together like that, we just all felt that there was something magic there, and decided to go back to Australia and reform the group. And we actually, for a little while, we still played under the name of Mississippi until we changed it to Little River Band.
Yeah, I know the story from Glenn Shorrock saying he saw a sign near Melbourne on a highway and suggested it, and that's how the band was named. Now, of course, Glenn Shorrock was the lead singer in that period, but he didn't sing every song. Let's hear a song that was written by our guest today, Beeb Birtles, that was another single from LRB that came out in 1976. Listening to Every Day of My Life, Little River Band, 1976, written and sung by Beeb Birtles. He's our guest on the line from Nashville, Tennessee. Got to number 29 in the charts. It's the title of the memoir that Beeb Birtles has written a few years ago that we can get in our local libraries here, Beeb. Tell me about that one.
Well, I was doing some shows with Glenn Shorrock and Graeham Goble, and this was after the loss of the Little River Band name, and we were performing as Birtle, Shorrock, Goble. And I came home from one tour one day, 1 year, I should say, and thought, if I don't start putting down my memories of my life and music, I'm going to start forgetting them soon. So I just started writing this book and didn't stop for about, it took me 7 years to write it, actually. I just kept going back and forth and asking people, certain things about what happened during that time. And eventually it came out as my memoir that was published 5 years ago. It's called Every Day of My Life, and it's basically the story of my life.
Well, you were born Gerard Bertelkamp from Amsterdam. Mm-hmm. You arrived in Adelaide as an 11-year-old, and I guess it's a good title for a life that's been full of adventures and full of successes and unexpected twists and turns.
It has, yeah. I mean, when I look back across my career, it's actually quite amazing how, things took its course, kind of thing. But, when I compare myself to some other guys in music, I really have only been in three bands, Zoot, Mississippi, and Little River Band. And I think that had a lot to do with my loyalty to whatever band I was in at the time.
Yeah, of course, you've, have longevity in this career and you're still working there in Nashville. I got a good friend listening, actually, Michael Carr from Sydney, who's a massive LRB fan, the classic lineup. He says, what's your favourite song by LRB and what's your favourite album?
Well, that's a difficult question because there have been so many, great songs that we've recorded. But some of my favourites would be Fall from Paradise, I thought was a great song from the Sleeper Catcher album. And, I have to say that Sleeper Catcher was my favorite album of all the albums that Little River Band recorded, just because it was just so perfect to me musically, as well as vocally. And the song that I've written that I get the most comments and questions about is a song called Light of Day that was on the Sleeper Catcher album as well, and that would have to be my favorite song that I've ever written.
Interesting. I'll play you my favorite. And it's one that you co-wrote. Just hang on the line, Beeb Birtles, here in the Legends series. This is the Little River Band, back to 1977, my favorite ever LRB song. This is Home on a Monday by Little River Band in 1977. Beeb Birtles co-wrote the song. He's on the line from Nashville, Tennessee. Can you see why I love that one so much still?
Yes. Now, I can totally understand that. Home on Monday was always one of my favourites to play live. And, you know, it really, in my opinion, should have been released as the third single from the Diamond Tina Cocktail album. But, you know, for some reason, the record company didn't think it was worth doing that. So, but anyway, I still love that song to this day as well.
And, you know, the thing is, it was just before Elvis died, wasn't it? I think Elvis died on August the 16th in 1977. There's a reference to him in this song, and it kind of takes us back to that period, doesn't it?
It really does. And, you know, there's a fantastic photo that I posted on the Little River Band Facebook page where Glenn Shorrock and his wife are sitting at Las Vegas Airport with he's holding a newspaper. And the headline reads, Elvis Heart Fails. And, you know, it just all encapsulates that whole song that Glenn wrote. I mean, it's basically most of his song. All I did was supply the music for the middle eight of that song when he kind of got stuck with it, you know. But always a wonderful song to play live and you know, so many people still love it.
And, of course, the young people don't realise there was a phone delay when you called long distance back in the day, right?
Yeah, that's right. And that's what he talks about as well, actually. So that's great.
What was your favourite lineup that you played in with LRB? You know, did you have a preference for, you know, the best lead singer, the best lead guitarist? What was your favourite?
Well, my favourite years were the ones with Glenn singing. And, you know, what people know or call the classic lineup, which was with David Briggs on guitar and George McArdle on bass. And that was the lineup that really recorded our biggest hits, you know, when you think about Reminiscing and Lady and Cool Change, so many of them, Happy Anniversary. That was all the classic lineup that recorded those particular songs. But I have to tell you that on October 14th, coming up, we've had all of our albums remastered, and there are a couple of new compilations coming out. The first one will be another kind of greatest hits that's actually called Ultimate Hits, And there's going to be an accompanying CD released that is called Masterpieces. And Masterpieces are all the album tracks that were favorite songs of fans that weren't released as singles. And so, you know, you'll hear your favorite song, Home on Monday, on Masterpieces, probably as well as the greatest hits.
Oh, wonderful. I can't wait for that to happen. Yeah. And I know there's a big resurgence of vinyl all across the world, particularly here in Australia. I'm going to play you another bit of a snippet of a collaboration of you and Graeham Goble from 1979. Beeb Birtles in the Legend series here on 101 FM. This is Beeb Birtles and Graeham Goble from 1979, I'm Coming Home. You guys just sang so well together. I guess it made sense to have a little bit of a side project while LRB was still going strong.
Yeah, well, I mean, the reason why we recorded that duo album was that we had all of these songs left over that were kind of rejected by Little River Band as a band. And so we approached our manager and record company and, with the idea of us recording a duo album. And that resulted in, you know, I'm Coming Home being the single from that. But I will tell you, Jason, that I'm Coming Home is actually being included on this Ultimate Hits that's coming out in October.
Oh, really? That's great. Any other duets with him?
No, just that one on this particular compilation. And you mentioned vinyl before. All of these new releases coming up are going to be released on vinyl as well.
That is excellent. Yeah, I think everyone wants to get their own vinyl collection up and running again to what it was, you know, in the 80s, 70s and 80s. You know, what about the dynamics between you and Graeham? You know, I hear he's pretty fastidious. He's a perfectionist.
He's very much a perfectionist, and back in the day of recording Little River Band, I would get frustrated at times in the studio because, you know, if you weren't giving him and the recording engineer what they wanted to hear, they'd basically tell you to go home and come back tomorrow. But
is that why Glenn Shorrock left? Was he, he was fired? Was it because he fell out with Graeham, or what was the story there?
Well, yeah, those two didn't really get along very well, but that wasn't the reason. I think we just it's such a long story, really, when you think about it. But you know, it was just time for us to part ways. I think that's the best way of stating it.
And what's your feeling now, seeing this other band, obviously with one, the bass player that joined you a few years in, kind of leading it, Wayne? What's your feeling seeing him continuing LRB in its current form?
Well, I mean, the word leech comes to mind.
Indeed.
And yeah, no, I mean, I've never seen them, or, you know, I mean, basically they're just a tribute band to, you know, what we achieved in our recording and live playing years.
Yeah, they're a cover band, really. That's how I describe them. But, you know, you must be so proud of all you've achieved. We're going to go to the news with It's a Long Way There. Maybe you could just give us a final overview on your career, what you're up to in Nashville, and introduce It's a Long Way There, which you mentioned a little bit earlier in the interview.
Sure. I mean, I moved to Nashville because I thought, you know, there was more to learn about songwriting. So I've been here for quite a few years now. And I'm still, you know, recording. My last recording was actually the latest Zoot song that was released that included Rick Springfield and Russell Morris on vocals with me. You know, I still dabble in music, although I would have to say that I'm probably, you know, somewhat semi-retired. But yeah, I mean, the song that started it off for us here in America, obviously, was the 8 minutes and 39 seconds, It's a Long Way There, which, you know, really, really showcased what we could do vocally on a song written by Graeham Goble.
What a song, and what a privilege it is to speak to you, Beeb. Thank you very much for all your time today and continued success. And all the listeners will be watching the re-release of these classic LRB albums coming up in October, and also your wonderful book, the memoir, Every Day of My Life.
Yes, thank you, Jason. Enjoyed talking to you.
Thank you, Beeb.